Peggy 3.
Anything he fancied doing, he had a go at it. I was almost sure we could get him to be a champion in the go-go. So we tied his feet to the pedal because he couldn't keep his feet on the pedal, so he tied his feet to the pedal in this go-kart. I don't think you'd actually learn how to brake or accelerate, did you?
I go one way, you know, accelerating down one end of the car park, and
next thing you know, he's hit this curve at the end of the car park, and the go-kart's flipped up and gone round and disappeared down a ravine.
And then after that, my parents pretty much said, yeah, no racing for you. And I think my mum just wanted to look after her her disabled son and do something else. When I got the opportunity to work for Project Cars, it was very minimal. They said, we just want you on board. What you can give us is fantastic. Your name, the fact that you raced, the fact that you're great with sim gaming. They said, you know, just drive the game a couple of times, write some reports, and just send it to us. And I was like, yeah, okay, well, that's great. But, you know, this is an opportunity that I've never had before, and I've always wanted to be a part of a game and put my thoughts and aspirations into a game. I followed my brother Lewis for my whole life. And I think it was just a natural thing for me to want to be able to race. But I thought it would be practically impossible for me to be able to drive, you know, because I was struggling to even walk with my condition. I was born 2 months premature. I've been diagnosed with cerebral palsy. And cerebral palsy is basically a condition affected by the brain. I think it's the right side of my brain is partially damaged, which affects my lower legs and the right side of my body. Cerebral palsy is all about tight muscles, the constant battle with it. So there's a lot of things I have to work on, which is the physiotherapy, also keeping on top of the strength. When I was about 15, I got this demo through the door. I took it upstairs, and that was my first sort of experience in a simulation game. And then I got a steering wheel and some pedals. I mean, I thought, if I can't have a career in real life, then why can't I have one online and in the virtual world? I entered the British Championship in 2009 and won the British Championship using buttons. It sort of just started the whole idea of, you know, if I get the opportunity to get in a race car, maybe I'll be able to do it for real. I pestered my dad for weeks and weeks and said, can I get in a race car? And he thought, you know, okay, well, I'll give him a little shot. I went to this driving school, which is owned by Jonathan Palmer. Within half a day, I was a second faster than the instructor straight away.
Yeah, I came last. I couldn't catch him or Lewis. It's impressive to watch Nick drive.
Us being Hamiltons, we're pretty much all or nothing. So we went into the Clio Cup, which is a step down from British touring cars, and it's the hardest or the toughest one-make series in the UK. Within 4 months, I went from a sim gamer to having my first opportunity to race a race car. Slightly Mad Studios is a very unique company. Everybody that's a part of the game and works on it is passionate about it. It's all driven by passion. My job is to take all of the cars in the game and develop them in terms of handling and physics, because I have that ability to mix between sim gaming and real life.
Nick did a lot of simulation racing himself, a lot of it. In fact, he was a simulation series champion. He has a good understanding of the nuances that we need to nail in order for a simulation to feel authentic.
To get the tire model right, having real-life drivers is critical. Nicolas is fantastic at picking out the smallest changes.
AJ might say to me, Nick, we need you to test X tires and, you know, give the feedback. So I've got to basically put myself in this program and then come back with the feedback that they need from it.
Nicolas happens to talk very similar to the way I talk about racing. it's a little bit like a real-life driver-engineer relationship.
Every car that is in the game is basically hand-built. It's completely different to any other car that you drive within the game. I've driven a lot of the circuits that are in the game, so all the attention to detail, just like the blades of grass and the bumps that are in the circuit, all those sort of things I wanted to really knuckle down on to make sure that the game was as strong as we could get it. Try and do the best job I can for them because it's something that I'm very, very passionate about. Something that, as I said, never thought I'd be in the position to do. If it wasn't for sim gaming, I wouldn't be where I am. If I didn't have that desire to want to play a game, it wouldn't have put me in this position, so my mindset wouldn't have been in the way it is now. So really, it stemmed from the whole sim gaming world, which I've only actually realized now talking to you. Because otherwise, I'd have just been in a wheelchair and I don't know where I'd have been. I don't know what I'd have been doing. Yeah, so it's pretty crazy.